Hello guys, it's Ben here from T-Rex Space Station. How are you all doing? I haven't seen you for a while, so I thought I'd do a quick video here. The reason why really is because I've got some packages in the mail. Woohoo! Let's get these bad boys open. Check it out. It's James Pond 3 on the Sega Mega Drive. And don't go anywhere. It's also James Pond Robo Cod. James Pond 2 on the Sega Mega Drive. Now, James Pond 2 is a game that I absolutely loved when I was a kid. It was a really great platformer that I played loads, and for some reason I haven't had a chance to get around to buying it again yet. But it just arrived in the mail this weekend, and I am so excited to play it. Now, I've never actually played James Pond 3 before, but I have seen a few videos that it looks really, really good. This would be a lot cooler if I had 1, 2 and 3, wouldn't it? But I couldn't find James Pond number 1 anywhere on eBay. I don't know if the first one is a slightly rarer game or something, or if people just don't want to sell it because it's so good, but I've never played that one either, and I would really love to have a go of it. But anyway, I thought it would be fun to show you a bit of gameplay footage of these two games today. So yeah, check it out. Well, here we are then. This is James Pond 2 Robo Cod. Now isn't that an awesome name? It's a parody not only of James Bond, but also of RoboCop. This is a really great inventive platformer from back in the day. One that I was very fond of. Oh gosh, I didn't know you could do that. So it's using this kind of go-go gadget mechanic here where you stretch up to things. Which is pretty cool, isn't it? Alright, so we go into one of the levels here. I like those platform games where you kind of start off in a kind of middle screen and pick a level as you go along. Like Castle of Illusion was with going into the doors. Yes, I remember going back quite a while now when Steve Benway did a video saying, where's the fun gone from modern video games? And I kind of agree with that. There were some very quirky little titles out there back in the day, weren't there? And, you know, the James Pond series would be no exception to that. Really kind of funny games with a sense of humour. Because why do we have to be so serious all the time? Now, graphically, this is really great, isn't it? It's this has got a kind of Winter Wonderland feel, this one. Oh, shit, I ate poison. What does that do? Probably makes you sick, I presume. There we go. Hamburgers! But, yeah, it's just very nicely done, isn't it, with the graphics. Sort of cartoony style. Oh, handles really nicely. Not a lot more to say, is it? I mean, you should probably all know about this game. Presumably most of you had it when you were younger. Oh gosh. A question mark box that spews enemies. Now this is bringing back some memories, it really is. Oh. I see. Oh, I remember now. I think you have to save the penguins or something, don't you? Oh god, get on it. There we go. How do I do the extendo thing? It's not doing it. Oh gosh. Don't know what's going on there. Yeah, I think you've got to save the penguins. I'm not sure you can finish the level till you've got them all, I think. Why am I collecting telephones? I don't know. Oh god, it's a pack. I've just been killed by a Pac-Man ghost. Are there not copyright issues here? Look, I must be in some kind of toy store here, because there's like, yeah. Oh god, I've done it again. There's like, what was it, ping pong table bats. Oh, shit. I don't even know what he is. He looks like a happy, psychotic glove. Oh, now there's three of them. Ah, look at that. So the enemies take two jumps to die. That's unusual. Come back here, you strange creature. It is a glove, isn't it? I'm not just making that up, am I? Oh, forget it. Don't need to kill him. Stars? Those have to be good. Oh gosh, I ate the poison again. Why are there jars of poison? Oh, hey up. There we go. That was very northern of me, wasn't it? Hey up, lad! Right, that's a bus with a wonky eyeballs, and he's jumped out, he's killed himself. Now that's not scary at all, is it? A bus with a squint jumping to his death. Right, how do we get up there? Oh, look at that. Right, now what happens? Oh, we do this.
I'm sure that was it. Was that a little computer that I just collected? They're very inventive with the collectibles, aren't they? Come here. There you go. Now that music is very memorable indeed. I can recall that from previous plays years and years ago. Because a good game should have music that really sticks inside the head. Oh wow! Look at that for a power-up! Is there any point to that? Do I get to keep that if I go to the next bit? No! Well, that sucked. Oh, oh, hello. What am I... Oh gosh. Oh dear, that was just awful. Stop it! That's what I wanted to do. Use the enemies to jump up. Oh god, there's lots of them. And there's some penguins. I love how James Pond is looking a little bit battered and disgruntled in the bottom left corner there. He's a bit worse for wear. Oh god, I've done it again. Now he's really looking ropey. Whoop. Here we are. Let's get some cherries. So there's no way to regenerate lives, is there? Or health? Doesn't look like it. I'm eating all the cherries that I can. If getting your 5 a day is not going to fix you, nothing will. Right. Mm-hmm. Such a little happy little trundling song, isn't it? What? Why did that... Why is he hurting me? I was jumping on him. That's inexplicable. Right, what's up here? Nothing. Oh dear, where is the last penguin? Gotta find the last penguin. Oh shit, I was just doing it again. Oh wow. Well, that wasn't very good. Right. Stop. There we go. Oh, they are both up there, aren't they? I think I made a right meal of this level, because it doesn't actually look like I had that much to do. The two penguins are here. And the exit's just back to the left. Oh, bollocks to it. Oh, there's two exits. What was that one that was a bit further up? Right, here we go. There we are. Well, I made a right meal of that, didn't I? He's just there chilling, bouncing from side to side like a hyperactive cod. On we go. Whoa, look. That means I must have finished that level. Oh, I remember this level. Classic. I really like the music. The level design's fantastic though, isn't it? You know, it's very colourful, very inventive. Lots of different things to see and collect. Mm-mm-mm. Great music. Right, where am I going? Let's do an extendo pants. Oh no, we don't need to. Why do those teddy bears look so sad in the background? Those aren't happy toys. There we are. What I do like about this game is that the jump is really substantial. It's a good proper jump that goes far. None of this faffing about with tiny little ones. Oh, hello. Just collected a pot of gold with a rainbow in it. Excellent. This is a bit tricky. Those look like those little potato things, croquettes. Presumably they've not made a level out of croquettes, have they? Not that that would be a bad thing, it would just be a bit unusual, wouldn't it? Look at that, it's just great how high you can jump. Does that sound mean that you've collected... Oh shit, oh god, what's it? He's a bit mental, isn't he? Right. Oh, I'm stuffed now. There we go. Right, drop down. Okay, what am I doing then? Must have to go down here. Christmas puddings. Very festive game, isn't it? It's set in a winter wonderland. Oh, sod it. I want that, whatever that is. Just points. For some reason I feel as though I must collect those little point things. Oh, there we go. Oh, this song is really going to get stuck in the old... Oh god, it's a spike trap. Well, that was cruel. What kind of kids game is this? And I've bloody done it again. Settle down. Oh, shit it. Ah. Right, well, shall we move on to the third one? If I can't even get past the first few levels on this one, it's not going to be good, is it? Well, here is James Pond 3, Operation Starfish. This one looks like it may be spacey. So we've gone from the Garden of Eden. That's classic. So, we've gone from a winter wonderland up to... Oh, hello. Up to space. Well, this looks and feels quite different. And Pond seems to have grown big legs this time. Whoa, what the hell? Look at that. I guess that's gravity, is it? That's very novel. Whoa, bloody hell, he runs fast, doesn't he? He's really making use of those legs. Whoa. You can punch. Look at that. You can punch? Wow. You're a very aggressive young fish, aren't you, James? Oh, gosh. I'm not quite sure how I'm making those bananas appear, but... Do fish like bananas? Oh, so... Yes, okay. A lot of running going to be involved in this game, it looks like. This is fantastic looking. This really looks great. So if you hold A, you sprint like a madman. Oh, wow. Remember when I was saying in my gameplay of Global Gladiators how I like platformers that have got some fast action and running and things in? Well, gosh, this feels really good in terms of that. I like platform games that flow very quickly. You know, that kind of recreate that first Sonic game on the Mega Drive. That's the feeling that I like. Are those bananas or are they actually supposed to be... They're supposed to be moons, are they? Little crescent moons? Right, let's sucker punch this guy. Oh, wow, look at this. Oh, cool, he just sucker punches the thing. This is badass. James Pond got badass in this game. Oh, gosh. Dearie me. Didn't collect any of the power-ups I was supposed to. Moons and teacups. Right. I like the little voice acting there. This just... Oh. It's a very interesting mechanic, punching stuff. I need to see if you can actually... Oh, God. Can you actually jump on them? Okay, you can, but it doesn't kill them. That's pretty novel. I've not seen that many platform games where you do that. It's kind of like you hold C and then you use left and right to punch. It's quite interesting. I mean, graphically, this looks like it's managed to even improve on the second game. It just looks fantastic. I can't really comment on the... Oh, and the controls are... Can't really comment on James Pond 1 because, like I said in the intro, I've not managed to buy it. And I might have played it a little bit when I was a child, but I can't remember. So I really can't tell you what it's like. But, you know, just looking over the two later ones, it looks like, yeah, things have just really continued to improve. The second game is fantastic. Oh, gosh, I've got a bit dizzy there. Great dying animation. And a bit of James Bond parodying there. That sounded very much like the, classic James Bond song, didn't it? Oh, God, stop it. Right, I'm getting too caught up. Oh, crap. I'm getting too caught up with trying to run too quickly, aren't I? Right, let's stop whizzing through and pay attention. Oh, he says. Right, I'm just trying to get used to not being able to jump on enemies or to steamroller them. It's deceptive because you start running and then you want to carry on and then there's just enemies there. Oh, how do I throw it? That's it. Right, come here. You're getting punched. That's the way to do it. Just chuck stuff at them. What does that do? Does that refill your energy? Right. Because you've got to be careful not to run too fast. You start to really build momentum there. Take that. I wonder if you get a gun. I wonder if you get the golden gun. Probably not. Oh, crap. Yeah, it's cool punching enemies, but... Oh, shit, I've done it again. It's slightly strange, because you have to get really close to them. Oh, man, that's game over. Right. Do you not get continues? Crap. No, you don't get continues. That's pretty brutal. Alright. Well, I can do the first level. That wasn't too hard. Who's this cheeky fella? Okay. Gonna skip through this level and go to the second one. Because I am bitterly disappointed with my performance. I should be ashamed of myself. Though, yes, I'm going to use the age-old excuse of talking and playing. Yeah, eat that. He's so badass. I love punching stuff to beat levels. I just like it. I should probably try and practice punching the enemies a little bit better, shouldn't I? Right, here we go. East of Edom. I can't be dying on the second level like this. It's just not cricket. There we go. Jumped over you, little sucker. I don't even know why I was bothering with those guys. I could just jump over them. Oh, you can jump on some of the enemies. Good. Just the ones that aren't wearing helmets. For added realism. Oh. Oh! Do you see what I mean? That's very cruel that you get to go so quickly. And then there's just enemies at the end of it. Shit, I've done it again. Every time. Right. Got to get used to this. What's up here then? Oh, there's some points up there. Right. They just put the enemies at the end of the bits where you start to get really fast. Which is, yes. Takes a little getting used to. Oh, go on. Right, my last life is flashing. I know that I'm on minimal health. Must be cautious. Do any of these power-ups actually give you some health? Something happened with my controls there. He blames the controller. Right, come on. For fuck's sake, I'd literally never learn. The music is just a bit James Bondy, which is awesome. Right, take that. A squash to you, little bugger. What's in these? Right, get some momentum. I love this kind of strange gravity running. Oh, look at that. Just skipped out half a level there with that epic leap. Don't get carried away with yourself. Oh! Oh! Right. I don't know why I'm just sucking at this. This looks like a great game. Great couple of games. I'm gonna have to try and find the first one somewhere on eBay. Take care, guys. See you all soon.